Sam was a popular boy at school, and when he left school, he had some qualifications, started working for builders and doing dry stone walling. Then he appeared to stop. The confidence and ease with which he approached the world seemed to disappear. And for a number of years, I would say two and a half years, he went into what he would describe his hermit mode. He became extremely reclusive, lived in a truck, barely saw his mother or me, and it was extremely worrying for parents to see a boy who'd been popular and well thought of disappear from the world. Three years ago, when Sam was backpacking in the East, we had a short postcard from him once a month. And one of the postcards, he just wrote that he'd met the girl that he was going to marry. At the time, I didn't know that he'd only met her for an hour and a half. It's one thing to believe and fall in love with a girl halfway across the world, but to actually see that one through, it's all credit to Sam that he's done that. It's one thing to be in love with a girl you take out every evening. To have a relationship with somebody who lives halfway around the world, in a way, is unreal. And Sam spent a year and a half writing to Martha, thinking about Martha, dreaming about their relationship. And it almost became a fantasy relationship. His whole life, really, was spent with this one plan to marry Martha. I was warned by Sam on the phone 2 days before we arrived of the culture shock that I would experience. I have travelled in India and I was surprised that in spite of the differences, the shock was not as great as I had thought. It's debatable whether Martha will enjoy and fit in to live English life. She's an adaptable person and I'm sure she will, but I think it's going to be extremely difficult for her. Here she has her large extended family all around her. There are always people in her house. Our nearest neighbours are a mile away. Thank you. wedding itself, it went through a number of emotions. Pride at my son being married to such a lovely person as Martha. The day was a very long one. The activity and the people arriving and the preparation of the food, which went on for hours and was fascinating to watch.
Pretty big. Devoted to this ritual dancing, which was congratulating the groom and the bride, the sharing out of the money that was handed over, and the endless dancing. The exciting
nature of the morning began to turn to a grueling ordeal. We were sitting under a tin roof. It was so hot, we were close to fainting. As the afternoon wore on, the heat became oppressive. The continuous rhythm of the drums began to drill into your ears, and it was a very difficult experience.
Thank you.